Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a 2GIG DBELL1-345 to your 2GIG Go control panel. This is a really nice wireless sensor to add to a 2GIG panel. A lot of people like the option of being able to trigger a doorbell and hear it at the panel. A regular doorbell obviously sounds in the house, but once you have a system and your doors are opening and chiming, then people want everything integrated. This DBELL1 allows you to do that. You replace your existing doorbell with this one, and you wire to your existing doorbell sounder in the house. And you can also program it to the panel, so now when you press your button, you hear the doorbell from your normal doorbell chime in the house, and it can chime at the panel. If you have TS1 touchscreen keypads out the house, it'll even activate through there. So it really is a nice option to give doorbell functionality integrated into your 2GIG Go control. We're going to show you how to program this device. Just like with all sensor programming, we need to jump into our installer toolbox menu. You can do that by hitting the Go control button and then entering our installer code. 1561 is our default installer code. System configuration gets us into our programming. First question in programming is select RF sensor number. 2GIG programming is done with question-based programming, and whenever enrolling sensors, question number one is the one you want to do. This next line where the white bar is what zone number are we using? We have yet to program anything to our panel, so zone one is free and ready to be programmed. We hit the down arrow, and we have select RF sensor type. Just like with the Honeywell system, this is like your response type. Sensor type will tell the system how to act when this device is triggered, and if it's a zone that's going to be sending to the central station, it'll tell the system what message to send to the central station. In our case, we don't want any alarms triggered off of this, but we do want the system to be able to know when it's activated. That would be zone type 23, no response type. All right, so it's not going to activate an alarm. Whether we're armed, disarmed, pressing this button will just make a chime. So we lock in response type. You can choose motion, or contact. And in our case, it's a contact. So we hit the down arrow. And we're on equipment code. This is where we tell the Go control panel the specific device we're using. So we scroll over until we see 2GIG DBELL. All the way at the end there, 2GIG doorbell. Go ahead and hit the down arrow to lock that in. And we can type in our serial number, which is our transmission ID number, TXID on the back of here. It says 0002-002-3816. The last seven digits are transmission ID. If you were looking at that long string of digits and you weren't sure if you were supposed to use the first four and the middle three, or the middle three and the last four, the easier way is to hit shift and learn and simply activate the device. We've already pulled the battery tab internally, which gives it power. So all we do is press the button. We can see that it learned in the 002-3616, and therefore we know we haven't made any manual input errors. We've also verified that the system is the sensor is good with a good battery. So we hit OK, hit the down arrow to lock it in. And we're telling the system it is a brand new device. If it was an existing doorbell, we could choose that. This information goes up to your monitoring company so that they would know, is this a doorbell you had from a previous company, or is it a brand new device they sold you? Helps them when troubleshooting. So go ahead and choose the proper equipment age, new or existing. Loop number is number one, and we hit the down arrow. Dial delay. We're not actually sending alarms on this event to the central station, but if there was status about this device, the dial delay could be relevant. So it really doesn't matter what you choose here. We always recommend to disable dial delay, so we're gonna go ahead and do that here. All right, so now we're on a screen asking us to construct our RF Sensor 1 voice descriptor for this particular device. So just like we do with all our wireless sensors that we're programming to our 2GIG, we can tell the system the specific voice description of what device it is and where is it. So, in our purposes, it's going to be our front doorbell. And if we hit insert, it puts the first word in the list. You get this list on the back of your 2GIG Go Control quick programming guide. We also have this on our website, alarmgrid.com. Each word equates to a 3-digit numerical value. There is no alpha keypad on the screen, so we just have to type the word. So front is 098. So typing 098 programs front. If we hit insert again, we can do doorbell, which is 277. We now have a nice clear description of what this device is and where it's located. Front doorbell. Hit the down arrow to lock that in. Reports is enabled. That means it would send to the central station. Of course, we're not really tripping alarms on this device, so that isn't really relevant, but supervision messages would go. So if you had low battery alarms, it would tell the central station. That's why we left it enabled. This supervision is whether or not you are supervising low battery alerts or range issues. So if you wanted to know that it was going low on the battery, or if for some reason the panel was no longer seeing the doorbell because it got damaged, was tampered with, or something environmentally changed the transmission between the panel and the doorbell, with it supervised, you'll know about that in advance. The system will periodically check for the doorbell, make sure the battery is good, so we always recommend that you leave that supervised. Now, chime is certainly something we want to enable on the doorbell. Otherwise, pressing the button is not going to do anything. We've already told it no alarm response, so don't activate an alarm. Without a chime, pressing the button will not do anything. So here we can choose what kind of chime do we want. Do we want to hear voice only, front doorbell? Do we want to hear ding dong with voice, so an actual ding dong, front doorbell? Or do we just want to hear the ding dong? Most people are used to a doorbell just making a noise without a voice descriptor, so we're going to leave it as ding dong number two. But you can go ahead and customize your chime with exactly how you'd like it to sound. And there are quite a few different options within here, so we invite you to kind of go through and take a look at all of the options and play with it and choose the right one for your doorbell. Hit the down arrow, and now we're on our summary screen. We can confirm that we've programmed it for no response type. It will not trigger an alarm. It is a contact. It's the 2GIG doorbell. The serial number is correct. It is a brand new device on loop number one. We have our dial delay disabled. There will be no delays in sending to the central station on events. And it is the front doorbell with reporting to the central station enabled and supervision enabled. The chime is ding dong number two. And if we skip and end and exit, the panel will reboot. It's locking in our programming settings with this reboot process. And then we can press our button and verify that it worked by hearing the ding dong chime message at the panel. So we give it a few minutes or a few seconds to wake up. We're going to hear it say disarmed. Ready to arm. A few seconds later, this lights up and then the screen will come on. System ready, not armed. And here we go. We're going to press our button. We get a really nice doorbell noise. Now we can go install this and we have properly programmed our 2GIG DBELL1 doorbell sensor. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We invite you to subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions on programming your 2GIG DBELL1, please let us know by emailing support@alarmgrid.com.